Hi, good morning all of you. Today we are continuing the lesson inverse trigonometric functions. And we discussed in the previous two classes about inverse trigonometric functions, what about the range, domain and all. And we started discussing the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. So we are continuing the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Properties of inverse trigonometric functions. And we already discussed few properties, and the remaining properties we are discussing today. See, one property it is cos inverse of minus 6 is equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. And you know here x belongs to closed interval minus 1, 1. X belongs to closed interval minus 1, 1. Because cos inverse x defined from minus 1, 1. And the next property is sec inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus sec inverse of x. What about x here? X less than or equal to minus 1 or greater than or equal to minus 1. Or we can write mod x greater than or equal to 1. Okay. Then next, cot inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cot inverse of x, and here x belongs to R since cot inverse function defined from R, its domain is R. Okay, so these all same type property, and among that one proof we can discuss, its proof we can give. Proof: put y equal to cos inverse of x. Then we can write x is equal to cos y. Sorry, cos inverse of minus x. So we can write minus x equal to cos y. Okay. So x is equal to minus cos y. Clear? What is minus cos theta? Cos of pi minus theta. So we can write this as cos of pi minus y, that is equal to x. So cos inverse of x is equal to pi minus y. Cos of pi minus y is equal to x, so cos inverse x equal to pi minus y. So we can take this y to here and cos inverse to that side. So we can write y equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. What is y? Y equal to cos inverse of minus x. So replace y as cos inverse of minus x. We are getting it as pi minus cos inverse of x. So we got one property. The same way we can prove the other two properties also. Clear? The next properties. Sine inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Sec inverse of x plus cosec inverse of x equal to pi by 2. Another property. Then the next one, tan inverse of x plus cot inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Here you know x element closed minus 1, 1. Here mod x greater than or equal to 1, and here x element r, since this function's domains. So first proof we can discuss. Okay, same way you can prove the other two also. For this proof, sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Put sin inverse x is equal to some theta. So we can write x is equal to sin theta. Correct now? What is sin theta? Sin theta we can write like this: cos of pi by 2 minus theta. this you are studying from 10th standard onwards. Cos of 90 minus theta is sin theta. Clear? So we can write cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus theta. Since x equal to cos of pi by 2 minus theta, cos inverse x equal to pi by 2 minus theta. We can replace theta with the sin inverse x. So it will come cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2 minus sin inverse of x. Then take that sin inverse x to here. So it will come sin inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. See, we got the identity, this property. Clear? The same way you can prove the other two properties also. Because the same application, see, sec of 90 minus theta is cosec theta. And tan of 90 minus theta you can write as cot theta. Same way you can give the other proof also. Clear? Next is very important property. So take it as very serious, very important property. See, tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. And one condition is given, xy less than 1. When the product of x and y less than 1, that time only you can apply this property. Tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y equal to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. Clear? And comes its proof. See, we can take x is equal to, or tan inverse of x is equal to some a. X is equal to some a. And tan inverse of y is equal to some b. Put tan inverse of x equal to a and tan inverse of y is equal to b. If tan inverse of x equal to a, what we can write? Tan a is equal to x. And from here we are getting tan b is equal to y. Clear? And last year we studied one identity, tan of a plus b. What is tan of a plus b? Tan a plus tan b divided by 1 minus tan a tan b. Correct? Okay. So this is equal to, what is tan a? Tan a is equal to x plus tan b is equal to y divided by 1 minus xy. Correct now? So tan of a plus b is equal to x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So we can write a plus b. What is a plus b? Tan of a plus b is equal to that value. So a plus b is equal to tan inverse of that value. Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Clear? What is a? A is tan inverse of x. So we got tan inverse of x plus b is tan inverse of y. Tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. We got the result. Very important result. Then see, in this result, if we are substituting y as minus y, instead of y we are taking minus y, what result we will get? Instead of y we can substitute minus y. So the result will come like this, tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of minus y. Y, instead of y I am writing minus y. This is equal to tan inverse of x plus, instead of y, minus y divided by 1 minus x into minus y. Y replace with minus y, that much only need to do. What is tan inverse of minus y? Minus tan inverse of y. We studied as one property. So this will come tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y is equal to tan inverse of x plus minus y, means x minus y divided by 1 minus x into minus y. So this minus and minus become plus, so x plus y, sorry, 1 plus xy. Clear? So we got another one result. while replacing y with the minus y in this first result, we are getting the second result. Clear? And one more result. Not only one more result, many results are coming. Its continuation, one more result. See, in the same result, first result, instead of tan inverse of y, substitute tan inverse of x itself. So, what will come? Tan inverse of x plus, instead of tan inverse of y, we took tan inverse of x itself. So, we are getting tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of x is equal to tan inverse of x plus x. Y we replaced with x. When x is equal to y. When x is equal to y, it will come tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of x itself. And tan inverse of x plus x divided by 1 minus x into x. So, we can write 2 tan inverse of x is equal to tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. So, we got one more result, third result. These all are very important result. Clear? Read it one more time. First result comes like this, tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y equal to tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy, tan inverse of x minus tan inverse of y equal to tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus xy, and the last one, 2 tan inverse x equal to tan inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Clear? Next result. 2 tan inverse of x is equal to sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Okay. And here it is given mod x less than or equal to 1. When mod x less than or equal to 1, that time only this property holds. Why it's so? After explaining the proof, I will explain how why it's so. See its proof. From the right side we can start. RHS equal to, what is RHS? Sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. In this right side, see, sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Instead of 2x by 1 plus x square, can we write it as sin of something by suitable substitution? Means we need to get, suppose sin inverse of sin we are getting, means we can write that function itself, means that term itself. Isn't it? Sin inverse of sin theta, we can write it as theta. Correct? So, like that arrangement is possible for this 2x by 1 plus x square. This structure you saw anywhere, 2 into some trigonometric function divided by 1 plus that trigonometric function square. Ah, yes, last year you studied sin 2 theta's result. Sin 2 theta is equal to 2 sin 2 theta, you studied like this. 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Correct? So, we can substitute x equal to tan theta in this result. Okay? So, put x equal to tan theta. X equal to tan theta. Where we need to substitute x equal to tan theta? In the right side. So, it will come sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. We can write it as sin inverse of 2, x replaced with the tan theta, divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Okay. So, this will come sin inverse of sin 2 theta. See, sin inverse of sin 2 theta, we can write it as 2 theta. When? Yeah, you studied like this one result. Sin inverse of sin x equal to x. When it is possible? When x element close to minus 1, 1. In that interval, In this interval only, this result holds. Sine inverse of sine x is equal to x, isn't it? So, it is given like this, that condition mod x less than or equal to 1 means x belongs to minus 1, 1. Correct, no? See, x belongs to minus 1, 1 means minus 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. Correct, no? And here we substituted x equal to tan theta. Clear? So, it will come minus 1 less than or equal to tan theta less than or equal to 1. That means tan theta varies from minus 1 to 1. Tan theta varies from minus 1, minus 1 to 1 means theta varies from which range? Tan theta varies from minus 1 to plus 1. So, theta varies from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. So, what about 2 theta? Multiply with 2. So, it will come minus pi by 2 less than or equal to 2 theta less than or equal to pi by 2. See? Sine inverse of sine inverse of sine x equal to x when x element minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Okay. So, see, 2 theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Means, we took this condition mod x less than or equal to 1. So, minus x less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. That condition is given because of this much satisfy. It means, this situation must satisfy. Minus pi by 2 less than or equal to 2 theta less than or equal to pi by 2. That means, 2 theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Then only we can write this is equal to 2 theta. Clear? So, to hold this condition, this is given. Minus x belongs to minus 1, 1. Where it is given? It is given with the result. Mod x less than or equal to 1. Because we studied sine inverse of sine x equal to x when x element minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Clear? Okay. So, we can replace theta with theta, we substitute x equal to tan theta. So, what is theta? Theta equal to tan inverse of x. So, we got sine 2x, sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square is equal to 2 tan inverse of x, or 2 tan inverse of x equal to sine inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Clear? Then next result. Tan inverse of x is equal to, see, now this is the third result for 2 tan inverse of x. First we studied 2 tan inverse of x equal to tan inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Now we studied 2 tan inverse of x equal to sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. Then the next one is 2 tan inverse of x equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. And the condition is given here, x greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Here also we can substitute x equal to tan theta for the proof. X equal to tan theta in the right side. So, it will come cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. So, it is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta is cos 2 theta. So, this we can write it as cos 2 theta. And see, you studied cos inverse of cos x is equal to x when x element is 0 pi. Closed interval 0 to pi. Isn't it? Check whether 2 theta, this condition gives us 2 theta belongs to 0 to pi. Can we check? So, here it is given x is greater than or equal to 0. That means x belongs to x from 0 to infinity. X greater than or equal to 0 means x from 0 to infinity. So, we can write 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity. That condition is given. Why we are checking this condition? Here we need to write cos inverse of cos 2 theta is equal to 2 theta. When you can write this one, cos inverse of cos 2 theta equal to 2 theta? When 2 theta belongs to 0 to pi. Means it should be in the principal value branch. Isn't it? So 0 less than or equal to x less than infinity is given there. What is x? X is tan theta. So 0 less than or equal to tan theta less than infinity. That means theta varies from 0 to infinity. See the graph of theta. Theta from 0 to infinity means, sorry, tan theta from 0 to infinity means theta varies from where to where? Tan 0 is 0. So theta less than 0 less than or equal to theta. And up to infinity it's going means theta varies from 0 to pi by 2. Tan pi by 2 is coming infinity. So it is coming pi by 2. 0 less than or equal to theta less than pi by 2 means theta varies from 0 to pi by 2. Multiply by 2, we will get 0 less than or equal to 2 theta less than pi. See, 2 theta is in between 0 and pi. So we can write cos inverse of cos 2 theta is equal to 2 theta since 2 theta is equal to 0 to pi. See, this situation must hold, that's why here one condition is given, x greater than or equal to 0. That time only we can give this proof. Clear? So it is equal to 2 theta. So what we got? 2 theta means 2, tan theta is x, so theta equal to tan inverse of x. So tan inverse of x. We got 2 tan inverse of x is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square by 1 plus x square. Got it? Now we are going to do one problem. The problem is given to prove that sin inverse of 2x into root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 sin inverse of x. And here minus 1 by root 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 by root 2. That condition is given when x belongs to minus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 in that interval. That time we can prove one identity or property, means a problem is given. Okay. How can we prove this one? Sin inverse of 2x into root of 1 minus x square. What substitution for x makes us this as sin of something? Which trigonometric ratio we can give for x? Suppose we are giving x equal to sin theta. What will come inside the bracket? 2 sin theta into root of 1 minus sin square theta. 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. So root of cos square theta is cos theta. So we are getting 2 sin theta into cos theta. So we are getting sin inverse of sin 2 theta. 2 cos theta sin theta is sin 2 theta. So I think we can substitute x equal to sin theta and we can do this problem. Can we do? Okay. So proof. Put x equal to sin theta. Because this expression makes one identity, nice identity, while substituting x equal to sin theta. That's why we selected sin theta. So it will come sin inverse of 2 into sin theta into root of 1 minus sin square theta. This is equal to, means LHS. Left side become sin inverse of 2 sin theta into root of 1 minus sin square theta. So it is sin inverse of 2 sin theta into root of 1 minus sin square theta is cos theta. This is equal to sin inverse of sin 2 theta. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. When we can write this is equal to 2 theta? When 2 theta belongs to the interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. We can check whether 2 theta lies between minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. What condition is given here? Minus 1 by root 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 by root 2. we have substituted x equal to sine theta. That means minus 1 by root 2 less than or equal to sine theta less than or equal to 1 by root 2. That means sine theta varies from minus 1 by root 2 to plus 1 by root 2. So what about theta? Theta varies from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. Correct now? So 2 theta varies from minus pi by 2 less than or equal to 2 theta less than or equal to pi by 2. See, 2 theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Isn't it? So we can write here sine inverse of sine 2 theta equal to 2 theta, since 2 theta belongs to the principal value branch of sine. Clear? See? This is equal to 2 into theta is sine x equal to sine theta, so theta is sine inverse of x. So we got the result. This is our right side. We given the proof for the result. Suppose instead of x, sorry, x equal to sine theta. Suppose we substituted x equal to cos theta. Instead of sine theta, suppose we are giving x equal to cos theta. What result will come? X equal to cos theta. Here it will come sine inverse of 2 into cos theta into root 1 minus cos square theta. So we will get 2 into cos theta into root of 1 minus cos square theta means 1 minus cos square theta sine square theta. So its root is coming sine theta. So we will get 2 cos theta sine theta. 2 cos theta sine theta also will give sine 2 theta. Means up to this step we will get correct while substituting x equal to cos theta. Isn't it? Sine inverse of sine 2 theta. Up to that step we will get correct. After that, when we will substitute, can we write it as 2 theta if we are giving x equal to cos theta? Let us check that one. See, the interval is given like this. So it will come 1 by root 2 less than or equal to cos theta less than or equal to 1 by root 2. That means cos theta varies from minus 1 by root 2 to plus 1 by root 2. So from the graph it is clear, then theta varies from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 4, pi by 4 to 3 pi by 4. So this is pi by 4 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to 3 pi by 4. Correct. Then what about 2 theta? Pi by 2 less than or equal to 2 theta less than or equal to 3 pi by 2. See, when we reach the sine inverse of sine 2 theta, we will be able to write it as 2 theta. Not possible, because 2 theta is not lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. It is out of that range. Isn't it? That's why we are not selecting x equal to cos theta to give the proof for this one, because we cannot follow after this step. We will not be able to write it as equal to 2 theta, since sine inverse of sine 2 theta equal to 2 theta only when 2 theta lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. It's clear? Okay. Then see, suppose this question, I am going to make a small change in this question. That is, sine inverse of 2x into root of 1 minus x square is equal to 2 cos inverse of x. How to get 2 cos inverse of x? To get it as 2 cos inverse of x, we need to get, see, what about here, while substituting x equal to cos theta, we will get up to here. Same way, we can substitute x equal to cos theta in this one, because we need to get a 2 cos inverse of x. So 2 theta means 2 cos inverse of x, so theta x must be cos theta. We can give x equal to cos theta. Then it will come sine inverse of 2 cos theta into root 1 minus cos square theta. That is 2 cos theta into sine theta will come. Same way we will get. Then sine inverse of 2, need to write 2x, x means cos theta, into root of 1 minus cos square theta. Then we are getting it as 2 cos theta into root of 1 minus cos square means root 1 minus cos square is sin square. So root of sin square is sin. So we are getting it as sin theta. 2 cos theta sin theta, that is sin 2 theta. Then see the interval. In this interval, will it be correct? 2 theta we are getting. If it is sin inverse, if it is x equal to cos theta, it will come like this. In this interval, it will come like this. So 2 theta naught belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That's why we will not be able to write this step. Clear? So this interval is not possible for x equal to cos theta. So we can take the another interval, that is next interval, 1 by root 2 to 1. 1 by root 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. We can check whether 2 theta lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. 1 by root 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 is given. So 1 by root 2 less than or equal to cos theta, we have given x equal to cos theta. So 1 by root 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. That means cos theta varies from 1 by root 2 to 1. Cos pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 and cos 0 is 1. So theta varies from 0 to pi by 4. 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 4. To make it as 2 theta multiply by 2, we are getting 0 less than or equal to 2 theta less than or equal to pi by 2. See that interval 0 to pi by 2. That 2 theta lies between the interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So 2 theta is a value from minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, means 0 to pi by 2, means in the principal value branch itself. Clear? So we can write it as, which step? Sin inverse of sin 2 theta, we can write it as 2 theta, because 2 theta lies between that interval. Then we are getting 2 into x equal to cos theta, so theta equal to cos inverse of x. That is our right side. So this is the second problem. Prove that sin inverse of 2x into root of 1 minus x square equal to 2 cos inverse of x when the interval is 1 by root 2 to plus 1. Clear? Okay. So now we can do some questions from first exercise. Exercise 1.1. Few questions balance you need to do. First question is given like this: sin inverse of minus 1 by 2. How will do sin inverse of minus 1 by 2? Either we can do like this: sin inverse of minus 1 by 2 is equal to some y. So we can write sin y is equal to minus 1 by 2. What value of y gives minus 1 by 2? Y is equal to minus pi by 6. Like this we can do. Or we can do directly applying the property. Sin inverse of minus 1 by 2. That is, sin inverse of minus x is minus sin inverse of x. So it is minus sin inverse of 1 by 2. So it is equal to minus sin inverse of 1 by 2 means 30 degree. That is pi by 6. So pi by 6. Sin pi by 6 is 1 by 2. That's why we are taking minus sin inverse of 1 by 2 is pi by 6. Clear? Next. Sec inverse of 2 by root 3. Directly you can write, you know, what value of angle gives 2 by root 3? 30 degree. That means pi by 6. Directly you can write it as pi by 6. Another one question. Tan inverse of 1 plus cos inverse of minus 1 by 2 plus sin inverse of minus 1 by 2. Many ways you can do. Either you can find tan inverse of 1, that is pi by 4, plus cos inverse of pi by 2 value you can write. Sin inverse of minus pi 1 by 2 value you can write. Sin inverse of minus 1 by 2 you can write. Then you can add. Or by using result, cos inverse of minus x is pi minus cos inverse of x. So it will come pi minus cos inverse 1 by 2. That means pi minus pi by 3. And sin inverse of minus pi 1 by 2 is minus sin inverse of 1 by 2. That is minus pi by 3. Like this you can do. Or see this result. Cos inverse of x plus sin inverse of x form. That is pi by 2. We studied as one result. Cos inverse of x plus sin inverse of x equal to pi by 2. So this sum we can write it as pi by 2. So like this you can do. Then add. What will come? Into 2, 2 pi, 3 pi by 4. Getting the value 3 pi by 4. So like this, very simple problems are there in the first exercise. So complete that first exercise before the next class. Means today itself you complete that first exercise. And study all the properties also, very important properties. All the properties you have to by heart. Okay, thank you.